Yeah, good morning to all of you. I'm audible. Yeah, so we'll just start in next 2 to 3 minutes, guys. It's 8:34, 8:37, we'll start the class. Group called A. So therefore I'm looking at 1, 2 and 3. So we know these three terms are in arithmetic progression. So central value will be my average. So I know one thing for sure, either you can do 1 plus 2 plus 3 divided by 3, which will be equal to 2, or you can also apply the weighted average concept. Similarly, when we are looking at the second set, right, again, the second question is talking about the average of only one group called B. Now, whenever I have one group, please understand, we use a term called average. Right, so average is applicable when I have a group of items. So which means I am talking about only one group of objects given to me. Only then we calculate the term called average. So again, it's asking me only the second part. So therefore, I can talk about either 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7 plus 8. I have 5 terms divided by 5. The answer is going to be 6. Or you can also apply. There are 5 terms in arithmetic progression. The average will be the central value, n plus 1 by 2th term. So my third term is going to be my average. Clear? Now, whenever I go with average of both the groups combined together. Now, whenever I have more than one group, okay? Whenever you have greater than one group, then the concept that we use is called weighted average. I'll spend some time on making you understand the concept, guys, okay? Now, when I'm talking about weighted average, now let's understand what is the formula to calculate the average. We know formula to calculate the average is number of terms into the average will give me the sum total. So sum total by number of terms is equal to average. We have done this, right? Now, when I have, let's say, two groups, I'm taking an example of only two groups. Okay, if I have two groups, then the formula would just extend. It will be sum total of first group plus sum total of second group divided by number of people in the first group plus number of people in the second group. Clear? Similarly, if I have three groups, then I extend this to sum total of three groups by number of people in the third group. Why am I focusing on this? Because sometimes what students do is, for the third answer, students say the average for the first one is 2. The average for the second one is 2. Then we write 2 plus 6 by 2, that is equal to 4. Now please understand, this will be completely wrong. Clear? If in case I am doing 2 plus 6 by 2, then what am I doing? I am calculating average of the averages. The question has not asked you to calculate average of the average. The question has asked you to calculate the average of both the groups combined together. So we'll stick to this formula, and that is how we will go ahead. Clear, guys? So the answer for the third question, I'm just writing it here. The answer for the third question would be nothing but sum total of the first group. That will be nothing but 6 we got from here. Clear? This is nothing but 6 by 3, which is equal to 2. Right? And this is nothing but 30 by 5, which is equal to 6. Clear? So sum total of the first group is 6. Sum total of the second group is 30. Now I have how many terms? I have 8 terms in both the groups combined together. So third group, so first group has 3, second group has 5. So your answer is going to be 36 by 8, that is equal to 4.5. Is this point pretty clear? How to calculate the average of more than one group given? Can I have responses, please? Yeah, perfect. I'll discuss, do not worry, if the same number of people are present. Yeah. We'll discuss, Sanjusha. Just have patience. We have just started the class. In the beginning of the class, please do not expect shortcuts. Let's understand the concept, Sanjusha. Yeah, let's discuss this. A lot of you are giving me 15 as the answer. I know why you're giving me 15. A lot of you have done 16 plus 14 divided by 2. I told you this will be completely wrong always. Why? Because 16 is the average of the first group, 14 is the average of the second group, and you are dividing by 2. So please understand, with this formula, you are calculating average of the averages. But the question is not asked you to find the average of the averages. The question is asked you to find the average of the entire class. Clear? Right? So when I'm having more than one group, I repeat, the formula for average will be the sum total of first group plus sum total of second group divided by number of people in the first group plus number of people in the second group. Clear? This can be further written as sum total in the first group can be number of terms into average. Remember the formula from averages? My average formula was sum total divided by number of terms, or when we cross multiply, we get number of terms into average is equal to sum total. So N1 into A1 is the sum total of the first group plus N2 into A2 is the sum total of the second group divided by N1 plus N2. This is how we fall. Now from the whole scenario, I am only given, so if I replace the values given to me, this is 16 into N1 plus 14 into N2 divided by N1 plus N2. Now please understand, since we do not know N1 and N2, I cannot get the answer. So more than 50% of you were correct. The answer is going to be cannot be determined. Here, if I'm just given the average, I cannot calculate the weighted average of the entire group, which means I need some additional information. Focus on the basics, guys. This is really important for us to understand the basics. For your kind of information, the basics remains the same for all the exams, be it CAT, be it ZAT, be it GRE, be it GMAT, and so on and so on and so on. Clear? And on this, we keep on building upon the models. Yeah, can we get the answer of this, please? Yeah, let's solve this. Now, what am I given? I'm given that I have a gang of girls and I have a gang of boys. So I'm given number of girls are 10 and the average age of the girls is 20 years. And in the boys gang, I have 40 and the average age of the boys is 30 years. So we know that if I have to calculate the average of the combined class, it will be the sum total of all the girls plus sum total of all the boys divided by number of girls plus number of boys. So from the graph, I know the number of girls and number of boys are 10 and 40. Now sum total of all the girls will be number of terms into the average will be the sum total. So this becomes 10 into 20, which will become 200. And this becomes 40 into 30, that becomes 1200. So sum of all the girls will be 200. Sum of all the boys is going to be 1200. So your answer is going to be 1400 divided by 50. So 5 into 28 is going to be your right answer. You? So I have number of girls. The average of 90 girls is 20. The average of 10 boys is 30. So I have girls, I have boys. Again, the same concept, the combined average of the class. The average of the class will be the sum total of girls plus sum total of boys by number of girls and number of boys. So the numbers are very lovely. The sum total will be average into number of terms. So this is 90 into 20, which is giving me 1800, and 10 into 30, which is giving me 1300. So sum total of girls is going to be 1800, sum total of boys is going to be 300, and therefore I'm dividing by 90 plus 10. So 2100 by 100, and the answer is going to be 21. Clear? Yep, simple. So now the whole logic here that you're looking at is when the number of terms are equal, the shortcut that you can apply is you can take the average of averages, because it will be proved here, okay? So sum total of girls will be 10 into 20 and sum total of boys will be 10 into 30. Okay, divided by, I'll do this as 10 plus 10. Now, if you simplify the calculation, this is 20 plus 30 divided by, I can write this as 10 into 2. So, 10 and 10 gets cancelled. So, eventually, your answer is going to be 20 plus 30 divided by 2, which will be nothing but 25. Now, please understand, the term to calculate the average of more than one group is weighted average. Okay. Now, weighted average is nothing but a balancing scale, guys. Clear? I apply some weight here and I apply some weight here. Right? So, we know that it will be bending towards an area where we apply more weight. Now, please understand, when I talk about weighted average, according to the formula, the weights are nothing but the denominator of the formula. Clear? Now, what are the denominators in these kind of questions? The denominator here is going to be number of girls and number of boys. Please focus on this part, okay? I'll be spending some time here so that the concept becomes clear for the students who are preparing for all the exams here. See, that's one of the reasons I'm not keeping GRE classes, GRE quant classes. You are learning all the concepts. My PPTs are designed that your basic concept will be clear. And then you attend the GRE class, we'll be taking the next level of questions. Right? So if you attend all these classes, your basic concepts of be it CAT, be it GRE, be it CRT, everything will be clarified. Okay? So please have some patience with me. So when I talk about weight, weight is nothing but the denominator. And what is the denominator? Number of boys and number of girls. Now tell me, if the number of boys and number of girls are equal, that means I am applying same weight on both the pans. So what will happen? The balancing scale will be balanced at the midpoint. Are you getting the point? Now, midpoint of what? Midpoint of averages. So one of the averages is 20, the other average is 30. One of the averages, so this is the average, this is a pan representing 20. It's like a number line, okay? This is 20 and this is 30. If I'm applying weight here, W1 and W2, if weights are equal, it will lie at the, it will be balancing. Balancing means this balancing point will be nothing but your midpoint. So therefore your answer becomes 25. Is this point clear, guys? What is the weight? Weight is nothing but the denominator in your formula. Quick responses, please. Now, if you understand here, what has happened? If I understand in this question, my balancing scale, clear, is this. And now if this is representing girls and this is representing boys, where do I have more weight? Again, the weight is the number of people. The weight is more on the girl side. And therefore, you see, your answer is more close towards 20. So your balancing scale will be bending on this side. Your answer is going to be close to 20 only. So therefore, your answer is going to be 21. Clear? So if you look at in the previous question, the weight was more on the boy side. And therefore, your answer was close to 30. So are you getting the logic, guys, here? So I repeat, in weighted average, your weights will always lie between, your answer will always lie between both the averages. Simple. The answer will lie between both the averages. This is going to be your midpoint. Now, this will be your midpoint when weights are equal, which means the denominator, the number of people is equal, it will be the midpoint. It will bend towards girls if I have more number of girls. So I write here simple. If the number of girls is equal to number of boys, then it is going to be 20 plus 30 divided by 2, midpoint. If number of girls is greater than number of boys, so please understand your answer will be between 20 and 25. Please assume a balancing scale, a weighing balance. Clear? Because the girls average is 20 and the midpoint is 25. So average will be bending towards this area. If the number of boys is greater than number of girls, clear? Then the answer will lie between 25 and 30. Is this point clear to all of us? Responses, please. Yeah, perfect. So let's move forward now. Yep. Can we calculate this, please? Yeah, let's see this now. Now he says that the average of girls in the class is 20. So I am given the average. Okay, so average of girls is 20 and the average of boys is 40. Find the average of the number of boys and girls. So please understand here, this is girls and this is boys. And the ratio of boys and girls given to me is 1:4. So boys will be X and girls will be 4X. Do not get confused because knowingly I have changed the values. So boys is to girls is X is to 4X. Now I know the sum total here will be 20 into 4X. That is 80X. The sum total here will be 40 into X. That is 40X. Divided by number of people will be 4X plus X. That is going to be 5X. So therefore your answer becomes 120X by 5X, which is going to be nothing but 20. Clear? I repeat, guys, please do not get confused. Girls' average is 20, boys' average is 40. Clear? But the ratio of boys is to girls is 1:4. Do not get confused here. Please read it carefully for all of you who are giving me an answer, which is beyond 24. So what is the most important takeaway? If I am given the ratio of number of people or denominator, clear? I can get my answer. Number of people is the denominator, kada? So therefore, if I'm given the ratio of denominator, I will get my answer. Now, yeah, can we get the answer of this, please? Yeah, please understand, in this case, the answer becomes cannot be determined. Do not go forward. That is where my PPTs are designed here. I trap you at each and every point. Clear? If you follow the basics clearly, your basics will keep on getting clarified here. That is one of the major reasons, you know, you're also liking these classes. The flow has been designed keeping the understanding levels of a student in mind, okay? So, the number of people is going to be 10 and 40, which is the number of boys is 10 and the number of girls is 40. And I know the average of boys and girls is 2:1. So let me take the average is 2x and the girls average is x. Now let's follow it. So sum total is average into number of terms. So here the sum total is 20x and here the sum total is 40x. So I have sum total divided by number of people. Clear? What is my number of people? Is my number of people in the form of x? No, my number of people is 10 and 40, which is a constant value. Clear? So therefore, your answer is going to be 60x divided by 50. Now, please understand, some of you are typing 1.2x. X is what you have assumed here. Somebody might assume A, somebody might assume Z also. The logic here is quite simple. If I have the answer in the form of a variable, clear? If I have the answer in the form of a variable, which means my answer becomes cannot be determined. Clear, guys? So please understand the comparison between them. In the previous question, I was given the ratio of number of people. So what we had, luckily in the denominator, we had 5x. So numerator was also in the form of x and denominator was also in the form of x. X got cancelled. So the concept here is simple, that if I'm given the ratio of denominator, I repeat, if I am given ratio of the denominator, we will get the answer. Clear? Clear? Otherwise, we will not be able to get the answer. The average will never be my denominator. Right? So perfect. Now let's go ahead. Can we solve this, please? Clear? Now, let's go ahead with this. Now, the question says the average weight of boys is 75 kilos and the average weight of girls is 60 kilos. If the average weight of the total class is 70, clear? Now, find the ratio of number of boys and number of girls. Clear? Now, let's try to understand the shortcuts also here, but let's try to understand the basic part. Now, I'm not given the number of boys and number of girls, but is asking me the ratio of number of boys and number of girls. So let me take the number of boys as B and the number of girls as G. Okay. Now, the average weight of boys is 75 and the average weight of girls is 60. This is the average. So what is sum total? The sum total will be nothing but 75B plus 60G. Clear? And I'm talking about the average of them divided by B plus G is equal to 70. Now, if you cross multiply, what do we get here? So we have 75B plus 60G is equal to 70B plus 70G. So when you rearrange, what do you get? You get 5B is equal to 10G, or you have B by G is equal to 10 by 5, that is equal to 2:1. Clear? This is the basic method in which we can solve. Clear? Now let's come down to the concept. Now let's understand what is allegations. Okay. Now, if I want you to define allegations, as I told you in the beginning, the challenge is always going to be, when do I apply allegations? Okay. So please understand, if you have to look at a few checklists, okay? My first checklist, am I calculating weighted average? CLCULA calculating weighted average. Clear? Number two, is it with respect to only two groups? Clear? These are the two important checklists for allegations, guys. Are we calculating weighted average? First checklist. Second checklist is it nothing but the weighted average of two groups or not? If these two points are being ticked, please understand you can apply allegations. So somebody was asking me shortcuts in the beginning, right? So it took 8 questions for us to understand when do we apply shortcuts, okay? Clear? So am I ticking both the boxes here? Let's try to check. Yeah, what is weighted average when I'm mixing more than two groups? The basic method here. Kasi ready. More than two groups, you will. I'll explain. Do not worry about it. I'll come back to you, Kasi. Right? So, what is weighted average? Weighted average is nothing but combination of or merging. Okay? I'm again further simplifying. Combination or merging of two or more groups into one. Clear? Into a single group in a way. In a single group. So I'm trying to make it more simple for you guys. Okay. So whenever I merge two or more groups, be it two or more groups or two or more solutions, anything, two or more quantities here in a way. Two or more solutions of liquids or two or more qualities of rice, wheat, or some anything, right? So two or more quantities in which are again in group, okay? To form a single group, that is called weighted average. Okay, so do I have two groups here? Yes, I have a group of boys, I have a group of girls. Clear? First things first. So I have a group of boys, I have a group of girls. So yes, I am calculating and I'm merging both of them, right? The average of the total class. So that means my weighted average box is ticked. Now, what are the number of groups that we are dealing with? Number of groups that you are dealing with here is two, because we are talking about either boys and girls. So both the boxes are ticked, which means it's a perfect case for us to jump into allegations. Clear? Now, what will come in the allegations? Okay. So what was the formula? We are calculating average of the total class. That means we are calculating sum total by number of students. Understand this. Now, sum total was N1 into A1 plus N2 into A2. Divided by N1 plus N2. This is again really important. So what is in the denominator? N1 is to N1 and N2. Kada? So forget that. Focus on this. Okay. So I have A1. I have A2. Clear? And together I'm given the combined average. So let's say the combined average is AM. Clear? If the combined average is AM, allegations is a crisscross method of calculation. Clear? And we'll take the difference of them. We'll understand what is the difference. Okay. The difference will always be. Now understand one more thing that we discuss here. I told you if one of the average is 60 and the second average is 75. We discussed that our combined average will lie between these two areas, anywhere between these two areas. Okay. So this is my combined average. Anywhere. It can be anywhere. Okay. Now, can I say my combined average is less than 75? So my overall average will be less than the larger value. Okay. And my overall average will be greater than the smaller value. Clear? Now, in this case, I am assuming that A1 is greater than A2. I repeat, A1 is greater than A2. Which means my average will be less than the larger value. So here you will write A1 minus AM. Clear? So average is greater than the smaller value. So that means the difference will become average minus the smaller value. Now, this ratio is nothing but the ratio of the denominator, that is N1 is to N2. Any doubts here? If you understand this, your job is done. You can answer CAT questions also here. Because there's nothing more in allegations to understand. So people are asking to repeat once again. I repeat. Let's take this case for example. So I have boys here, that is 75. I have girls here, that is 60. Okay. I have girls 60, which is lower end, and boys 75, which is higher end. So even if he is not mentioning this, I know my overall average will lie anywhere between 60 and 75. Is this point clear? Kasi Reddy, Teja, and others who have doubts. That my overall average will lie between the average of both the groups. Okay. Now, if it is lying somewhere here, let's say which is 70. Let's apply allegations quickly here. So I have boys 75. I have girls 60. My overall average is 70. Now, if I am taking the difference, difference is always larger minus smaller. So here the difference will be how much? 75 minus 70. Here, what will be the difference? This will be 70 minus 60. Okay. Now, since this is representing boys and this is representing girls, understand this final ratio will be number of boys is to number of girls. Clear? It will be corresponding to this. But more than that, the most important part is what is happening here. This is my average minus 60. I'm writing 60 as my smaller value. Okay, 75 is my larger value and larger minus average. So always remember this, that since your average is lying between these two ends, right, it is always going to be your larger value minus average. Clear? And the second case will be your average minus smaller value. These two formulas should always be standard. I again repeat, if you are representing 75, Ashok, what is 75? 75 is boys kada. So below boys, you will get the ratio of boys only kada. Yes, Mahati, this is applicable only when weighted average is given of end of two groups only. This is girls given kada, Ashok. So below girls, you will get the ratio of number of girls only. That order is really important. I am going with boys here and girls here. The final ratio will also be ratio of number of boys and number of girls. Clear, Ashok and others who have this doubt? Yeah, if you have understood this, guys, then nothing is going to be difficult from now on. As I told you, the important challenge is to understand when do I apply weighted average and how do I apply weighted average. Clear? Let's move forward. Let's try to understand different types of questions. Yeah, 2:1 is the answer, Sirisha. And that is boys is to girls, okay? 70 is to 60 is 10 ikada. And 75 minus 70 is 5. So 10 is to 5 is nothing but 2:1. And which will be nothing but the ratio of boys and girls. Clear? So the answer is 2:1. Yeah, let's look at this now. So it's an extension of the previous question, right? So let's understand this part clearly. So this is boys, this is girls, and the average is 70. So when I allocate them, this is nothing but 70 minus 60, and this is nothing but 75 minus 70. So we get this as what? 10 is to 5, which is nothing but 2 is to 1. So I repeat, the number of boys by number of girls is equal to 2 is to 1. I guess there's some issue in the question. Find the number of boys and number of girls. Find the number of boys if the number of girls is 40 here. Okay. This is not and, this is going to be if. If the number of girls in the class is 40. Okay. So number of boys by number of girls is 2 is to 1. So let me replace it. I do not know the number of boys and I know the number of girls in the class is 40. So when you cross multiply here, what do you get? So I get the number of boys is equal to 40 into 2, which is equal to 80. Simple. Clear? So this is how we apply allegations. So I'm taking you step by step to the next levels, guys. Now let's try to understand first, how do we apply allegations here? Take 1 minute, build your thought process. Yeah, let's first understand here. In what ratio must, because see, there are limited models in your allegations here. If you understand what is your denominator, the job becomes pretty easy. In what ratio rice be mixed with 20 kilos per kg will be mixed with 30 kilos per kg to get a mixture worth 24 rupees per kg. Now, if you understand, this will be what the quantity, let's say the quantity of first one is N1. So 20 into N1. So when I say per kg is nothing but I'm trying to represent that as my average here. So here this becomes your average. Okay. So average into this plus 30 into N2 divided by N1 plus N2. It's really important to understand this. I am mixing two quantities or two qualities of rice. So weighted average box ticked. Am I having two groups? Yes. Right. So this is going to be a formula, which means I will allocate 20 and 30. Clear? This is 20 first group, 30 second group to get a mixture. So I'm mixing them in the ratio of something, right? So again, I repeat, this will be 30 minus 24. That is larger value minus average. You get 6. And this is 24 minus 20. That is average minus smaller. So 6 is to 4. Therefore, the answer is going to be nothing but 3 is to 2. Clear? Let's move forward, guys. Yep, guys, I repeat, per kg. Now, always remember one thing, guys. When I talk about the average marks being 70, let's say you have written six subjects, okay? And I'm saying that the average marks is 70. So we discussed in averages class that we can assume that 70 is what you have scored per subject. Clear? So somebody has a doubt, sir, how can per kg be the average? So if I'm saying the average is 70, which means on an average, you have scored 70 per subject here. Nothing else. This is what I mean by average. Clear? Similarly, when I'm talking about 6 per kg, the average price of that rice is rupees 6 per kg, because understand your sum total is going to be number of terms into the average. Clear? So again, one is costing me 6 per kg. The second is costing me 9 per kg. I am mixing both of them. Somebody again asked me, sir, how do we understand weighted average? Guys, a lot of you are joining late. In that case, going back to 10 questions is going to be a little difficult. Clear? So I repeat, two checkpoints, guys. Is the question falling under the concept of weighted average? I define weighted average also. Mixing of two groups or merging of two groups. So I'm mixing two qualities of sugar, right? So yes, it is a weighted average question. Clear? Now second, is it weighted average of two groups? Yes, I'm only mixing two qualities of sugar. Yes. So if these two boxes are ticked, my question gets qualified as allegations. Now you're calculating 7 per kg. 7 per kg is your total cost is in the numerator. Per kg is in the denominator. You can also understand this way. Clear? Which means your denominator will be number of kgs. So if you allocate the cost per kg, 6, 9 and the average is 7. So this will be 2 and this will be 1. I repeat, 2 will be 9 minus 7 and this will be 7 minus 6. So 2 is to 1 will be the number of kgs of these qualities. Now the question is clearly told you that rupees 9, I have 30 kilos. So 2 by 1, I do not know the quantity of the first part. And I know the second part is 30 kilos. Clear? So therefore, the value of x is going to be 30 into 2, which is going to be 60. So more than 90% of you gave the right answer, guys. Clear? Guys, if you are stuck here, I repeat, the easier way to do is basic method. We do not know this, right? Let me assume x kgs, okay? So 6 into x is the sum total plus 30 into 9 is the sum total divided by x plus 30 will be my overall average. And as per the question, the overall average is 7. So guys who have not picked up how to apply allegations, best friends approach, guys, do not forget this. So 270 is equal to 7x plus 210. So this I bring up here and this I bring up here. So what do we get? We get the value of x is equal to 60. The same thing in allegations. If you want to go ahead, 6, 9, 7. If I allegate this, this becomes 9 minus 7. If I allegate this, this becomes 7 minus 6. And the ratio is 2 is to 1. Clear? So final step, 2 by 1 will be the quantity of this and the quantity of this. Clear? So the value of x is going to be 30 into 2. That is going to be 60. Yep. Can we get the answer of this, please? Yeah, let's understand this question now. Yeah, so it says the cost of oil is 100 rupees per kg. Okay, after adulteration with another oil which costs 50 rupees per kg, Ram sells the entire mixture at 96. So understand what am I given? I am given cost 1 is 100, the cost 2 is 50. But what is 96? 96 I am given as the selling price. So you cannot equate cost price with selling price, guys. Okay. So selling price given to me is 96, but the beautiful part is I'm given that there's a profit of 20% that is made. Clear? Now let's apply this. So can I apply profit percentage and selling price to get my cost price? I know CP into multiplying factor is equal to SP. So 20% more means 120 by 100 of, I do not know the cost price, is equal to 96. So we get the cost price is equal to 80 rupees. So I repeat, I am mixing two qualities of oil. One quality costing me 100 rupees. Second quality costing me 50 rupees. I am mixing both of them, which means I am calculating weighted average. And I have two qualities only. If I have two qualities, both the conditions help me to apply allegations. Clear? To get a mixture which is costing rupees 80 per kilo. This is really important. Clear? This is my cost price. This is my cost price. So overall should also be my cost price. Simple. Now if I allegate average minus lower and larger value minus the average. Clear? So in what ratio will I mix them? I will mix them in the ratio of 3:2. So most of you are correct. The answer is going to be 3:2. Clear? Do not worry if you are getting 2:3. You will get 2:3 if you are placing 50 on this side. The question will be clear in the exam. Do not worry. Clear, guys? So I repeat, I am given cost price of 1, I am given the cost price of 2, but I am given overall selling price, but I am also given profit percentage. So by using profit percentage and selling price, I get my answer, I get my overall cost price. Clear? After getting my cost price, I directly apply and get my answer in the form of allegations. Clear? The other method, as we already discussed, it is nothing but the basic method. I will assume, first I have to convert 96. So cost price into 120 by 100 is equal to 96. One second, guys. This got disconnected. Yeah. Yep. So I repeat, we will have to calculate the value out here. Clear? So first things first, we'll look at cost price into 120 by 100 is equal to 96. So 00 gets cancelled. 12 ones are 12 eights are. So my overall cost price is equal to 80. So basic method is, let us say that we have x kgs or x liters. I guess there's a mistake in kgs out here. So 100 into x plus 50 into y divided by x plus y is equal to 80. So you calculate, you get the ratio of x is to y will be nothing but 3:2. Clear, guys? Moving forward to the next one. Yep, can we solve this, please? Yeah, let's look at this question now. So this question says two kinds of rice are mixed in the ratio of 2:3. That means the quantities are mixed in the ratio of 2:3. They're sold at 22 rupees, resulting in a profit of 10%. Okay, so this is my selling price. If the cost price is given, that means I have to convert my overall selling price into cost price, right? So my overall cost price is a profit of 10%, which means into 110 by 100 is equal to 22. So 00 gets cancelled, 11 ones are 11 twos, so I get my overall cost price is equal to 20 rupees. Okay. The cost price of per kilogram of the smaller quantity is rupees 14 per kg. Okay. So I have 14 per kg. I do not know the second one. Okay. I'm mixing these two quantities to get an overall price of how much? 20 rupees. Clear? Now always understand, we discussed that your average, guys, please understand here. And the, okay, first one more thing. The average will always lie between both the ends. I know my average is 20. Clear? And I know one of the values is 14. So if 14 is less than 20, can I say X will be greater than 20? Yes, no, yes, no. Can we have a response here, please? We have already discussed that the average will lie between both the quantities. So I'm writing my average is 20. Okay. So if 14 is less than 20, so obviously the second value will be greater than 20. Perfect. So we discussed this also. When we allocate, it will be the larger minus the average. Clear? Is 2. Average minus the smaller. This will be the ratio of quantities. And I know that 14 is representing smaller quantity. Now among 2:3, the smaller quantity is 2, right? So this will go on these lines. So this becomes 2:3. Below 14 will be smaller value, guys. So all I get here is X minus 20 by 6 is equal to 2:3. So 3 ones are 3 twos are. You cross multiply. X minus 20 is equal to 4. Or the value of X is equal to 24. So most of you were correct. The answer is going to be 24. Okay, so every step by step, you'll understand how to proceed and get your answer.
So we can take.
Kirti, I believe you have joined a little late, Amma. Clear, guys? Please do not assume that 10 plus 14 is 24. Clear? Naveen, he has already told you that the cost price per gram of the smaller quantity, that means out of 2:3, the smaller quantity is 2. So 2 parts is equal to 14. Clear, guys? So moving forward, I have already discussed the basic methods enough number of times. So we are moving ahead, guys. Sure. How many of you need basic method? Yeah, so most of you, only one person, I guess, Chinni Sai, I believe you joined a little late, Amma. Just go through the video once again, because every question you're asking me to repeat the basic model. I believe you have not picked up allegations, which means you have joined a little late. You cannot take three parts as 14 years, Vaishnavi. He is clearly telling you smaller quantity is 14. So 2:3 lo smaller quantity. What is smaller quantity? Harshita and Vaishnavi. 2:3. What is the smaller part? That's 2, no? Clear, Vaishnavi? Yeah, so follow the question. You'll get the answer very easily. Yeah, so there are two, Sachin, there are two milk solutions, no? 40% and 70% kada kana. Yeah, let's look at this. So let's go with the basic method first. 9 liters of 40% milk solution. So I want to find the percentage of milk solution in the mixture of two solutions, right? So my overall milk solution, so concentration of milk here, or the milk percentage will be my quantity of milk. Quantity of milk divided by overall quantity of the liquid multiplied by 100. Clear? So if I have 9 liters of 40% milk solution, so quantity of milk coming up from the first part is going to be 40% of 9. Plus, if I have 3 liters of 70% milk solution, so the basic method says I will get 70% of 3 divided by total quantity, that is 9 plus 3 into 100 becomes your answer. Clear? Basic method. Now let's apply the tools. Is it weighted average? Yes, of course, because I'm mixing two different solutions. One solution is a 40% milk solution. The second solution is 70% milk solution. So I'm mixing two to combine into one, weighted average. Do I have weighted average of two groups? Yes, so we have weighted average of two groups, so we can apply allegations. Clear? So here, if you know the basic formula, the denominator will be the quantity. So if you ignore the quantity, what is left out? Percentage of milk. So I can look at 40% of milk. I'm mixing with 70% of milk. I do not know how much will I get, but after mixing them, I know that their ratio will be nothing but 9:3. So if this is 70, we know this is larger minus average. So this will be 70 minus X is 2. This will be X minus 40. And these two should be equal. So eventually we have 70 minus X by X minus 40 is equal to 3:1. So we get 70 minus X is equal to 3X minus 120. So what do we get? We get 2x is equal to 4x, right? Yeah. 4x is equal to 120 gets added here. That becomes 190. So therefore, the value of x is equal to 190 divided by 4. So that's 4 4s are 16. We have 30. 4 7s are 30. And then we have 4 7s are 28. And then we have 0.5. So 47.5, all of you giving me 47.5 is the right answer. Clear? Yeah, can we solve this question, please? Now, just one second, guys. I would like to just make you understand here. Sometimes the question might also ask you in this question, find the percentage of water. The question might also sometimes ask you, find the percentage of water. Now, how do you go ahead with that? Please understand, if it is 40% milk. Yeah, you can go by two methods here. Either you calculate, either we go from the previous question, we are calculating 40, 70, X, 9:3. We get the value of X is equal to 47.5. So if milk percentage is 47.5, my water percentage will be 100 minus 47.5. One way. Or the other way is, if there's a 40% milk solution, which means the remaining, that is 100 minus 40, there's a 60% water solution. Clear? So this solution, I can club this as, there is a 40% milk and 60% water. Similarly, this we can get 70% milk and 30% water. So if you directly want the water percentage, we can say I am mixing a 60% water solution with 30% water solution. I do not know what will be my water percentage overall. And this is in the ratio of 9:3. You will definitely get here the value of x is equal to 52.5. Clear, guys? If you're given milk and water, sometimes you might also give you alcohol and water solution. Clear? So whenever you have these kind of mixtures, you can always understand the method of calculating both the quantities. Any doubts? Yep, let's have this, please. Yeah, so it says, now the question is talking about milk and water solution, right? It's a very easy question, in fact. So if you want to go by the basic method, let us also quickly simplify the basics. When a milk and water solution of 40% milk is mixed with another 57% milk to have equal amount of milk and water. So let me assume x liters of this and y liters of this. So what will happen here? So for the basic method says 42% of x plus 57% of y will be the quantity of milk divided by my overall quantity into 100. When it's saying equal amount of milk and water, which means the percentage is 50%. This is the basic method for Chinnisai. Okay. Now the logic is quite simple. I'm mixing a solution of 42% with a 57% to get a 50% milk solution. So you get the ratio in which they're supposed to mix is nothing but 7:8. So almost all of you gave me the right answer. The answer is 7:8. Clear? Yep. Can we solve this, please? If 18 liters of X percentage milk and water solution, okay, is mixed with 20 liters, so I'm mixing two quantities. So 20 liters of 75% milk solution. So very standard question by now for us. So I have a X percent milk solution, I have a 75% milk solution, I'm mixing them to get a 48% milk solution. Clear? So I already have a larger minus the average. Is to I will have average minus smaller. This should be in the ratio of the corresponding value of X is how much? 18 liters. And the corresponding value of 75% is 20 liters. Clear? So your final answer is going to be 27 by 48 minus X should be equal to 18 by 20, which is nothing but 9 by 10. Clear? So that gives you what 270 is equal to 48 into 9 minus 9x. So take this 9x on this side. If I take 9x here common, 9x here, so I take 48 into 9. Can I write 270 as 9 into 30? So if you are good at calculations, you could have got the answer by now. So this 9 and this 9 gets cancelled. So the value of x is equal to 18%. All of you got the right answer. It's 18%. Your basic method is again simple for Chinni Sai. X percentage of 18 plus 75% of 20 divided by 18 plus 20 into 100 is equal to 48%. X percentage of milk and water, which means I'm assuming X percentage milk. So 18% milk is what we are looking at. Yep, so let's look at this question. So two solutions of diesel and petrol. See, the whole idea of this question is, you know, these kind of questions come up a lot, where if you understand properly, you can also save a lot of your time here. Okay. Now it says two solutions contain petrol and diesel in the ratio of 2:3 and 3:7. So I'm mixing two solutions. So therefore, definitely it is allegations. So that in what ratio they should be mixed so that the final ratio of diesel in petrol and diesel is 7:13. Now, one way in which you can go is the way we saw the proportion of petrol is 2 by 5. The proportion of petrol in the second one is 3 by 10. I'm mixing both of them to get 7 by 20th part of petrol. This is one way to look at it. Clear? You solve this, you get the answer is 1:1. Now the best part in these kind of questions is when the denominator is 20 together, make everybody 20 into 4 into 4 into 2 into 2. So 6 by 20 minus 7 by 20 minus 6 by 20, you will get 1 by 20 is to 8 by 20 minus 7 by 20, you will again get 1 by 20. So therefore your answer is going to be 1 is to 1. Clear? Now second way to look at this question is, since we have seen the last questions in the form of percentage, now tell me, if petrol is to diesel is 2 is to 3, clear? Can I say petrol percentage in the solution is 40%? That is 2 by 5 into 100. So I have a 40% petrol solution, okay? And the second one, that is 3 is to 7. So can I say the percentage of petrol in the second one is 3 by 10 into 100? That is nothing but 30%. Now overall, petrol and diesel is 7 is to 13. So can I say the percentage of petrol overall is nothing but 35%? I do not need to calculate 30, 40, and this is the mid value. So therefore the answer has to be 1 is to 1. Clear? 7 by 13 is the ratio of petrol and diesel, Rajesh. We are calculating petrol by total, because we are talking about amount of petrol plus amount of diesel. Which part here? Basic method or the second method? First or second method? You can go with diesel also, Teja. Yep, let's look at one more time, guys. A lot of you have doubts. Basic method, I do not know how many. So if you want a basic method, let me assume x liters of this and y liters of this. Teja, allegations, you can go with only one thing, Kanna. You can't go with both of them. Either you go with petrol or you go with diesel. Right, if you want to go with the basic method, now understand the final ratio of petrol and diesel is 7 by 13, okay? So the numerator will be the total quantity of petrol, the denominator will be total quantity of diesel. So quantity of petrol from the first one is 2 by 5 of x. Quantity of petrol from the second one is 3 by 10 of y. Clear? Quantity of diesel from the first one is 3 by 5 of x, and quantity of diesel from the second one is going to be 7 by 10 of y. You equate this and solve, you will get x is to y is 1 is to 1, guys. Okay? I'm not resolving, I'm just explaining you once again. Now, if you want to go, you can either go with petrol or you can go with diesel. If you are going by percentage concept, if 2 is to 3 is the quantity of petrol and diesel, that means 2x is petrol and 3x is diesel. We had seen this question in percentages chapter. So the percentage of petrol will be 2x by 5x into 100, that will be 40%. If 40% is petrol, I can also have 60% as diesel. Clear? In the second one, petrol and diesel are in the ratio of 3 is to 2. If I take 3x and 7x, then this becomes how much? 30%. If 30% is petrol, then 70% becomes diesel. Now convert percentage here also. If I take 7x and 13x, the percentage of petrol is 7x by 20 into 100. That is 35% petrol. If there's 35% petrol, which means there is a 65% diesel. Clear? Now if you allocate, you get the ratio as 1 is to 1 in both the cases. Clear, guys? Moving forward now. Just 1 second. Yeah, just 3 more questions, guys. Yeah, let's understand this here. Two ways in which I can go ahead. Goods are purchased at the rate of at 1450. One third of the goods are sold at a loss of 10%. Understand this model, okay? So if there's a 450 worth goods, one third of them, so that means cost price of one third of them becomes 150, and the remaining will be how much? 300. Clear? Now these ones are sold at a loss of 10%, and the remaining are, so at what percentage should I sell the remaining to get an overall profit of 20%? First, let's understand the basic method, and then I'll tell you the allegations also. First of all, is it allegations question? Of course, yes. I am mixing two groups. Clear? I am mixing two groups. If I'm mixing two groups, definitely it is a question of allegations. Clear? So how do we go with the basic method? So there is a loss made in the first one of 10%. I do not know how much profit am I making from the second one. Divided by, please understand, I'm calculating my overall profit percentage. To calculate my overall profit percentage, my denominator has to be cost price. Repeat, my profit percentage is profit by CP into 100. So what is my cost price? That is 150 plus 300 multiplied by 100 should be equal to 20. You can do the calculation back at your end. For me, this is important to understand how do we apply allegations. Okay. Now we discussed in allegations, we will get the ratio of denominators. So forget this, which means if I allegate my profit or loss percentages, I will get the ratio of their cost price. Now you need not calculate 150 and 300. Please understand, one third of 450 is to two third of 450. What will be my ratio? 450, 450 will get cancelled. 1:3 will also get cancelled. So my ratio is going to be 1:2. Clear? Now, definitely this is going to be the larger value. So it is larger minus the average. So this becomes X minus 25, okay? Is 2. It is average minus the smaller. So what do we have? We have X minus 25 divided by. Sorry. Overall should be 20. X minus 20. By 20 minus of minus 10 will become 30, is in the ratio of 1:2. So 2 ones are 2 15s are, when you cross multiply, X minus 20 is equal to 15, or the value of X is equal to 35. So therefore the answer of this question is going to be 35%. Clear? So you can remember cost price based questions. So you can always bring your denominators on those lines. Clear? So denominator will be cost price because I'm calculating profit percentage. One more variant in the form of simple interest and compound interest. This is simple interest. with when I reply to your query. Yeah, perfect. Yeah, let's look at the last question of the day, guys. The next question is on average speed. We will discuss that in the next class. Do not worry about it. Once we are done with speed, distance and time, we'll go ahead. Yep. So Rahul takes home loan of 25 lakhs from a bank at an interest of 10% per annum. Clear? So 10% of 25 lakhs is what he pays as the interest. Now, he avails a car loan at 12% per annum. So the interest paid by him is 12% of 5 lakhs. Now, the overall average will be upon the principal value. So the total principal is 20. So interest is always interest percentage of the principal. Yeah, so it's interest by principal into 100 will always be your rate percentage. If I'm going for more than one thing, so interest of 1 plus interest of 2 by principal of 1 plus principal of 2 into 100 will be your overall answer. Clear? Now this is what we are supposed to calculate. Now if you observe, this is nothing but weighted average problem. Clear? If this is the weighted average problem, clear? If this is the weighted average problem, then what am I looking at here? So we will get the ratio of denominator. So ignore. So if I allocate my rate percentages, clear? I will get the ratio of their principal value. So for 10 lakhs, I am borrowing a 25 lakhs of principal. And for this, I'm borrowing a 5 lakhs of principal. So this is my larger value. So this becomes 12 minus x is to x minus 10. Will be in the ratio of 5 is to 1. Clear? So I go with 12 minus x by x minus 10 is equal to 5 is to 1. So we get 12 minus x is equal to 5x minus 50. Here, or we get 62 is equal to 6x, or the value of x is equal to 62 by 6, that is 10.33%. Clear, guys? So we have one more question which is left on average speed model. Do not worry, that I'll be discussing in speed, distance and time class, right? And I'll explain you the allegations concept of that as well. So with this topic ends here. Thanks a lot, guys. So guys who have doubts can stay back. Yeah, starting with Ashok's doubt. What is Ashok's doubt here? Why are we equating with 1 is to 2? Kana, Ashok, 1 is to 2 is nothing but the ratio of their cost price, Ashok. Thank you, guys. Thanks a lot. I will get the ratio of the denominator, Ashok. So 150 is to 300 will be nothing but 1 is to 2. Thanks a lot, Naveen. Thank you for your compliments. Is Ashok with me? Guys, anybody who has question number 18's doubt, please ask. What is the doubt, Sirisha? I cannot explain the whole thing again. I already explained two times, Sirisha. Allegations is only for two things, Ashok. Two sets. One is to two is the ratio of their quantities here. Rate ratio of their cost price, Sirisha, 150 and 300, we get the ratio of their denominators. So 150 is to 300 is nothing but 1 is to 2. Clear, Sirisha? Question number 19. Yeah, go ahead. What is your doubt? Rajesh and somebody else was asking me question number 19 as an answer. What is the doubt? Then Rajesh, you can please revisit the video, no? Just because you missed the question does not mean I'll be explaining it n number of times. Kadagana. Just because I'm having a doubt session doesn't mean that it gives you the liberty to ask just because you missed the question. So if you missed the question, I'm sorry. You can again go back and cross-check the video. If there is any doubt, I'm here to clarify your doubts. I'm not here to re-explain the question here. I'm done, Vinny. I'm sorry. I've made the class open for question number 18. Vinny, there's no other shortcut, Vinith. Vinny. Vinny, that is wrong. X minus 10 by 2, that is wrong. You cannot come out with shortcuts based on the final value, Vinny. Because every question you are doing that, Vinny, I'm observing that. Because final value is coming up with something and you're trying to come up with some other logic to get the final value. Kana. Please don't do that because it's not depending on values. The values can change, but the process will not change. Yeah, what is the doubt with question number 17, please? Sai, your college records this at their back end. And once they send me the link, only then I'll be able to upload, Sai. I believe you have posted this question for the 6th time today. Clear, Sai? Waiting for doubts for question number 17, please. Jhansi, we are discussing today's question number. Yeah, I told not one quantity. If there's a petrol and diesel. So either I pick petrol or I pick diesel. This is what we are doing here. Petrol, diesel. We have milk. We have water. We have alcohol, we have water. Clear, Harshita? So whenever you have these things, either I pick milk or I pick water. This is what I mean by any one of the quantity is enough. Clear, Harshita? Yeah, perfect. Next doubt, please. 17, I'm done. Can we move to the another doubt, please? Anybody who has a doubt? We get the same answer. Yeah, you'll obviously get the same answer, Kada Ashok. If you have 50% petrol, you'll get 50% diesel, Kada. Diesel spelling chood ra kuncho. If there's 50% petrol, we'll have 50% diesel, Kada. So you have to get the same answer in both the cases. Your answer does not change here. Because please understand, this is not the quantity of. This is the overall ratio of the overall quantity. That should not change. The percentage of petrol and the percentage of diesel will change. Are you getting it? The overall quantity should be same. This should never change. Yeah, Dharani, coming back to 9th one, you have asked many times. Let me go. Yeah, tell me, Dharani, what is your doubt here, Amma? If the number of girls is 40, Amma. 75, 60, 70, Dharani. So if I alligate this, this becomes 10. If I alligate this, this becomes 5. This is the ratio of boys is to girls, okay? So 2 is to 1. I do not know the number of boys, and number of girls are 40. Clear, Dharani? So number of boys are nothing but 80. Any other doubts, please? So let's wind up the class, guys. Yeah, perfect. I don't think there are any other doubts. So let's wind up the class here, guys. Thanks a lot. And I repeat, once your college gives me the recording, I'll be right away uploading in the WhatsApp, in the mobile application. Cleo, thanks a lot, guys. Have a great day.